Now let's talk about lighting in Revit. We'll look at two types of lighting, both daylight and artificial lighting. So to start with, for daylight, if we want the shadows and the light to look accurate, which you typically would, we need to make sure that our location on Earth is set properly. On the Manage tab, we select the Location command, and then we specify our city, or we could even enter a specific address. Once we've done that, another important thing that we need to do is set True North. So in any plan view, we can change the orientation from Project North to True North. And then if nothing changes, most likely it hasn't been set correctly. And if nothing changes, most likely True North has not been set correctly. True North and Plan North can sometimes be the same though. But with the orientation of the view set to True North, we can use the Rotate True North command and then rotate the specific amount that's needed. So now we can see that this would be the correct True North. And then we set the orientation back to Project North, and it looks like it undid what we just changed. But in fact, Project North or Plan North is how we want the view to look when we're editing it and how it would be placed on a sheet. But anytime you're talking about daylighting or energy modeling, True North would always be used. So I can close the site plan view. And then one more important thing to get this particular interior view or any other camera view to have the correct lighting, we need to click this little sun icon on the view control bar and go to sun settings. Oftentimes the default is set to lighting, which technically is basically a fake light source over your right shoulder based on these settings. So we want to switch it to still. And you'll notice that now it knows about your location, and you specify a day and a time. And then you can also specify whether shadows are artificially cast on an imaginary plane at level 1. But if you have a topo surface or a topo solid, you can turn this off and the shadows would cast on that actual surface in your model. Finally, there is an option to save presets of these settings, so you can switch between different times of day. And I'll make this a little bit later in the day, and we'll click OK. And then now, before even doing any sort of rendering, if we turn shadows on, these shadows will be accurate for that location, day, and time. So this is really important to get that right. The other thing we can look at in terms of lighting is artificial lighting. One thing I like to do to make sure that the light sources are set up properly, and even just to see which light fixtures have light sources, is to go to the Visibility and Graphic Overrides dialog, VV or VG on the keyboard. On the Model tab, expand the Lighting Fixtures category, and then turn on the light source. So that's a built-in subcategory, and any Revit light fixture families that have been set up properly with the light source will have this geometry show up that defines what the light source distribution looks like. So if we select this spotlight and go to Edit Type, these fixtures that are set up properly will have this photometric section. And you can adjust things like the color temperature and the intensity of the light source. And then when you create a rendering, if we go back to our render dialog and talk about lighting, there's exterior options and interior options. Typically, sun only would be an exterior option. But if you don't have any artificial lights, there's no point selecting this. But when you do have artificial lights and you're selecting artificial only or sun and artificial, it can take quite a bit longer to process the rendering because there's more calculations involved. But for the interior renderings, you'd definitely pick one of these interior options. Otherwise, the rendering tends to be too dark. So you want to make sure you select that because the exterior option is default when you create a new camera view. So that's a really quick look at lighting, both daylighting and artificial lighting in Revit.